By this time tomorrow, NASA's newest rover, Perseverance, will have touched down on the planet Mars. And if all goes well, cameras from a San Diego company will capture some of the first images that we will see. Our Jeff McAdam joins us live from their lab in Sereno Valley with the story tonight. Jeff.
Hey, Andrew. Yeah, that's the right way to word it, the right phrase, if all goes well. This company right here behind us, they've been working on this for a long time, the last 7 years or so. But the landing situation, getting the rocket on the surface of Mars, could be a challenge. If it doesn't go well, this could be 7 years of hard work down the drain.
Since 2014, scientists here at Malin Space Science Systems in Sorrento Valley have been at it.
So we got five cameras. Five.
You heard him. Michael Ravine says the team has mounted five cameras to NASA's newest rover, Perseverance, which will land on Mars Thursday. The team has built similar cameras in the past that orbit the moon and Jupiter, but this new version is capable of giving us a closer look than we've ever had before.
And it's basically a four and a third to one zoom. So that's going to be pretty cool to see that actually working on Mars, because nobody's ever flown a zoom lens to Mars before.
That is if the rover can land safely. Described as 7 minutes of terror, the spacecraft carrying the rover will descend toward the surface at a speed faster than 12,000 miles per hour, then slow to a hover, allowing the rover to drop. Most scientists holding their breath, but not Michael, at least not yet.
Look, if it crashes, it's not my fault. If the cameras don't work, that's my fault. Then it's just like, okay, let's turn the cameras on, see if the cameras work, because that's our part of things. That's the part we're responsible for.
That part may not come until Friday when they flip the cameras on for the first time. But if all goes well, like projects in the past, we'll be seeing pictures from the surface for years to come, all thanks to this San Diego company.
In my experience, people are most interested in seeing pictures. And so you give them pictures, you can say, okay, this is what it's like to be standing on Mars. They can connect with that, and they like that. And they feel maybe it was worth a little tiny fraction of their tax burden to do that.
Yeah, so Michael says, yeah, that's what we've been working on for the last 7 years. He goes, right now, we're working on something for 2027. That's pretty cool. They're going to attach the cameras to a drone that'll fly through one of Jupiter's moons. Something to look forward to. Certainly, Andrew. Back to you.
That's incredible stuff, Jeff. Very exciting. Thank you very much. Glad San Diego gets to play a part in this. Also, you know, some names are going along for the ride. In fact, more than 10 million names are etched into Perseverance. Last year, NASA asked people around the world to submit their names, and millions did just that, with the space agency etching those names into three microchips on board the rover. NASA says each inscribed name isn't taking up a whole lot of room. It's smaller than 1/1000th the width of a human hair. But you're part of it nevertheless.